quantum mechanical features were first uncovered at the turn of the 20th century, when Max Planck came up with the first consistent theoretical explanation of the intensity of thermal radiation emitted by an object of a given temperature. This phenomenon, known as black body radiation, sits at the junction of statistical mechanics and electromagnetism. Statistical mechanics describes the behavior of systems involving many particles, such as gas molecules in a container, and forms the foundations of thermodynamics, where we then can assign a temperature and a pressure to the gas. It rests on the idea of Ludwig Boltzmann to assign probabilities to the different possible states of the system. Electromagnetism provides a description of light as a superposition of plane waves of different wavelengths lambda, where the electric and magnetic field components oscillate with a frequency given by the speed of light c divided by the wavelength. Black bodies emit thermal radiations across all frequencies, but in a spectral analysis, different frequencies appear with different intensities, which moreover show a systematic dependence on the temperature of the body. This intensity distribution posed many riddles, which were resolved when Planck introduced the idea that energy appears in discrete units, known as quanta, of h times the frequency, where h is a fundamental constant that now carries Planck's name. While Planck did not provide a microscopic explanation of this quantization, Einstein came up with the idea that these are units of the energy carried by the light wave, which can be thought of as composed of particles, now known as photons. And he utilized this idea to explain the photoelectric effect. De Broglie further developed this idea by linking particles of energy E and three-dimensional momentum P to a wave of frequency f given by the energy divided by Planck's constant, and wavelengths lambda given by Planck's constant divided by the magnitude of the momentum. This defines the properties of a monochromatic plane wave, which we nowadays would write down in a complex notation as indicated here. Here, k is the wave vector of length 2 pi divided by the wavelength, and omega is 2 pi times the frequency and is known as the angular frequency. R is position in space, t is time, and the dot denotes the vector dot product. In terms of these quantities, the Planck and de Broglie relations read as energy E equals h bar omega, momentum P equals h bar k, where h bar is Planck's constant divided by 2 pi, and is known as a reduced Planck's constant. Similar qualitative concepts were applied by physicists such as Niels Bohr to find phenomenological answers to a number of important outstanding questions, such as for the discrete energy spectra observed in the emission and absorption of light by atoms. However, it took until 1925 that Erwin Schrödinger came up with a general equation that tied all these aspects together into a consistent and general formalism. And he indeed applied it directly to derive the energy spectrum of the hydrogen atom. This still left a number of interpretational questions, in particular about the exact role of the wave function, but it didn't take long before physicists such as Bohr and Werner Heisenberg identified the key role of measurements, and Max Born put forward the interpretation that the wave function encodes probabilistic information about the properties of a particle observed in such a measurement. The theory owes its present mathematical formulation to people such as Paul Dirac, David Hilbert, John von Neumann, and Hermann Weyl, while Dirac, along with Wolfgang Pauli, Enrico Fermi, and Richard Feynman, are just a few key players to elevate it to a fundamental theory of elementary particles. And John Bell helped to fully appreciate some deeper conceptual aspects related to entanglement. While many of these features are of course already relevant for the statistical mechanics behind black body radiation, they become much more apparent when one studies individual particles. We will therefore come back to the specific phenomenon of black body radiation only at the very end of this course, and instead focus on settings involving individual particles, which also reveal much more clearly what is meant by the probabilistic interpretation of the wave function. For a detailed motivation, I have selected two key scenarios: Compton scattering between photons and electrons, and the double slit experiment carried out for individual particles. Compton scattering confirms the key role of photons in light of a given frequency, while the double slit experiment clarifies the role of the wave function in this description. Both scenarios will also provide the backdrop to identify some mathematical features of this connection, which we then can generalize to write down the Schrödinger equation. Therefore, let us next have a look at Compton scattering.